everyone, and welcome to another episode of Annie's Replay Casting. I'll be your caster, Annie, aka Android, and this is going to be match number 220-605-6914. Looks like we have some awesome lineups here on the side of the Radiant. Let's start things off and introduce Unforgiven on the Ursa. We're going to have SS on the Spectre. Down here in the bot lane, it's going to be Krilla on the support Skywrath Mage. Over here towards the mid, we've got Coach Adam on the Ricky. And finally, it's going to be Squirtle playing the Lina. On the side of the Dire, a team that looks like they are made up of mostly hard carries, we have got a Spanish Sentence on the Phantom Assassin. We're going to have Quemer on the Legion Commander. Down here towards the bottom, it's going to be Bray on the Tinker, followed up by Bray on the Clockwork. And finally, we are going to have some more Spanish Sentences on the Omni Knight, so it looks like it's going to be a pretty fun matchup. I'm thinking Radiant are really going to be going for the early game push strat. They've got a lot of early damage with the Skywrath Mage, with the Ursa, but they've also got some decent carry into the late game with the Spectre, as long as she's able to get farm, so maybe a little bit of farm contest going on here. It looks like it might be a jungle Ursa as he snaps up the Tangos and the Quelling Blade, but we'll see what happens here. We are going to have a 1-1 rune split. Up top, Phantom Assassin was able to grab it. Down bottom, it did go the way of the Ursa, so the mid laner's not going to be getting their hands on any runes, but that's a-okay. Lina's saving up for the bottle. She should have it relatively soon. That'll be a nice advantage for her. Meanwhile, Tinker did start out with the bottle, and that's going to put him at a little bit of an advantage here in the lane. In terms of last hitting, both should have a pretty easy time. There's not going to be a whole lot of bloodshed just yet, as both heroes are in that lane for their level 6. Down bottom, Krilla's going to do his best, does level up the Arcane Bolt rather than the Concussive Shot to make sure he gets out as much right-click harass damage as possible onto the Clockwork. So Clockworks are known for having kind of a miserable time in lane, and up against a Spectre, the longer Spectre's able to free farm without pressure from the Clockwork, the better. So it's going to be looking pretty good for her. Meanwhile, up top, we're going to have a solo Ricky offlane that could be pretty challenging as soon as some Sentry Vision comes out. Omni Knight having no items, that's going to put him at a disadvantage. He will be flying in part of his soul ring, so he's going to go straight for his items rather than going for the support items for the lane. Bray down here is getting pretty low. Krilla once again could follow up the Arcane Bolt, but might want to conserve some mana. Still has two clarities, so really should be spamming out that key whenever it's off cooldown, just getting back the Clockwork constantly, making sure Spectre's having the best time possible. Probably going to hop in here, stack up and pull some of the camps, but Clockwork does have an Observer Ward blocking the small spawn. Mid lane Bray popping a point into March of the Machines, going to be giving Lina a little bit of a hard time. She has to get back and really not be as aggressive in the lane as she'd like to, but after picking up her bottle, she's going to feel very sustainable. She's going to have enough mana to put some more points and cast out that Dragon Slave. Surprisingly, no pickup of the Lightstrike Array. Usually you see Lina go for kind of a split between the first two, but she does opt to go for a Fiery Soul, which I guess helps when she follows up the Dragon Slave. For now, it's going to be Omni going in. Is contesting Phantom Assassin for a little bit of farm here, so might be getting a little bit greedy, as Phantom Assassin really needs as much farm as possible, as much solo XP as possible, and we'll see how much Ricky's getting out of this. His last hits aren't ideal, he has 3, but the lane's pushing in his favor pretty heavily. Mid lane, we do see Bray on the Tinker getting kind of low. He's out of regen from his bottle, so he's going to have to crow that one in whenever the courier comes through. And, well, we'll see how he gets out of this one. As Lina, she does still have the Dragon Slave ready to go, and that could be a pretty sizable nuke going the way of the Tinker. Meanwhile, down bottom, looks like Bray will end up being the first blood. Spectre actually securing that kill. I thought it would go to the Skywrath Mage, but that's going to give Spectre some really nice early gold. She's now working with about 800 in her favor. Meanwhile, up top, it looks like Coach Adam did fall. The Ricky was scouted out. He just spent a little too long out of his invis form and was punished for it. So Omni Knight, he will be completing his soul ring, not having a whole lot of gold to work with to pick up any dusts or sentries, though. Lina, she's getting very low as well, gobbles down the last of her bottle charges, and we'll see how deep she wants to initiate onto the Tinker. So for now, looks like Krilla going in, continuing to harass, does pick up that final, or the first point in the Concussive Shot, able to slow down the Clockwork a huge amount. But again, I think he should be spamming out the Arcane Bolts just a little bit more. He did have to gobble up both of his Clarities, but he could fly in something like a Mango, or just take a quick trip back to base, and that extra bit of mana for the extra bit of harass is going to be hugely helpful up against a hero that needs to be out of XP range like the Clockwork. Coach Adam going in pretty deeply, trying to dive onto an Omni Knight, but that's going to be a big mistake here, as Omni Knight does have the Purification ready to go in 2 seconds. So he's going to be most likely having the Phantom Assassin jump onto the Ricky, but again, suffering from no vision, not able to punish Coach Adam as much as they could. Like this one range creep is really adamant about punishing Krilla. He's gonna be able to juke that away. Meanwhile, up top, Ricky having some issues with the degen aura. Omni has opted to start with a 1-1-1 build, puts a second point in the purification, and that's gonna mean Ricky cannot get as close as he'd like. He has to deal with the degen aura if he wants to get up close and personal with the PA. Tinker is able to pick off the Lina in the mid lane. That's just courtesy of a well-placed heat-seeking missile. Does so much damage even at level 1, and the level 3 in the laser is really a huge nuke to follow up on, so Lina is a little bit squishy to be going up against a Tinker now that he's got some levels. Bray having to go into some defensive cogs here just to stave off the harass from the Skywrath Mage. Meanwhile, up top, Coach Adam will take a purification right to the face, so that Omni really showing his power. He's now picking himself up some items. It's going to be a dust of appearance, so finally going to be able to punish that Ricky for himself being maybe a little bit too aggressive for an early game Ricky. He is only level 5, doesn't have that level 6 yet. Even at level 6, may not pick up the ultimate, but again, only 2 points into the cloak and dagger, so not able to get that fade time as quickly as he'd like. For now, Spectre doing pretty well. Her and the Ursa keeping up the top of the last hit chart by a decent margin. The Ursa has been in the jungle for the most of the time, and well, he's getting what he needs to out of it. He has his Iron Talon, he's got his Morbid Mask, and that means he could Roche at any time. Looks like Coach Adam might reveal himself, will end up blinking back to a creep, does take a dagger to the face. They're not going to spend a dust for this just yet, they don't want to dive too deeply. So Spectre gonna continue to farm, has to deal with the Rocket Flare from the Clockwork, and well, should be A-okay, has the Fairy Fire if he needs it, and also gonna be a nice shared salve there from the Skywrath Mage, so SS feeling very, very good. Again, the Spectre now has pretty much everything Spectre needs to be successful, has the level 5, almost level 6, and once the Haunt comes out, Spectre can go into the fights, can have much more of a presence in the team fights, and we'll see what item Spectre opts to go for first. She's saving up a good amount of gold, so it could be the Radiance. I've also seen Spectres just build up the stats and go for a Drums or an Urn into a Diffusal Blade, into a Manta, and that works pretty well as well. Up top there was a dust cast, so Ricky, now the dust wearing off, a little bit of a BM there as there's really no follow-up from the Dire on the last dust, and there is going to be a rotation in from Lina. She might want to go up top and see what she can find here. She does have her level 6, but she did already spend it and is pretty low on mana as far as mana goes. Now Krilla popping a ward here into the lane, just out of vision of the tower. So that's going to be some decent high ground vision, as there might be a Light Strike Array coming off the Lina. Nice laser, though, chunking down a good amount of her health. The Heat-Seeking Missile coming through, and now Lina might have to go back to base. She's out of regen, no more bottle sips for her. Meanwhile, Ursa gonna be taking a couple more camps, and is gonna be flying in the first part of his face boots, and may want to take Roche sooner rather than later. We're 7 minutes in, which, you know, that's a quick Roche on if he wants to go for it, but he certainly has the levels to do so. He's got his level 6, he's got his lifesteal from the Morbid Mask, that's really all he needs to get down the big guy, and we'll see if he wants to rotate into the pit or continue to jungle. I think the earlier the Roche on, the better here, as Radiant has a really powerful early game lineup. Up top, there is going to be a dust onto the Ricky, but really, what's the follow-up? They're underneath the tier 1 tower, there is going to be a blink in from Phantom Assassin, there's going to be a courier as well, but now Skywrath Mage is here, there's a purification, we'll end up getting the Ricky very, very low. Ricky is still in vision, now the dust fades off. Meanwhile, mid lane, there was a kill on the Tinker as the Spectre rotated through, using that Haunt very well, so no kill up top, there was a return kill in the middle, so Dire not quite hitting their stride just yet. The Phantom Assassin, she needs a little bit more, she's going to go for the first item, Battle Fury, which it'll help her farm really, really well, but how late can Dire really push? You know, how long can you keep PA farming? Because a PA farming up against a Spectre free farming, Spectre's gonna come out on top every time. Bray gonna be going in. He has his level 8, so he's had the hookshot for a while, but his mana isn't exactly ideal. Looks like he will be flying in some Tranquil Boots, getting his health nice and sustainable. Meanwhile, Lina, she is making this Dire jungle her home, and Dire have really no vision. Omni Knight has not been doing the best job buying wards. He used up the last of his dust, and we'll see if he's gonna buy more here, but again, we're 8 minutes in the game, no flying courier, not a whole lot of observer vision, very little sentry vision as well for the Ricky, and It's going to be really difficult. Dyer does not have a lineup with a lot of support, so the Omni needs to be playing the hard five, and we'll see if he's able to do that. Looks like Bray will take a smokescreen right to the face, gets blinked on, and oh my gosh, there's going to be a Lugan and a Blade. Looks like Ricky is able to finish off the Tinker with the last strike of his ult. And now Coach Adam on the run here, but again, Omni, no vision, goes through with the Purify, but it's remarkably off the mark. Meanwhile, Spectre continues to free farm. She's going to go for the early Diffusal Blade. I like this pick a lot. I think Dire are very mana-dependent, being able to purge off their helpful abilities. That's going to be fantastic. And now Krilla is going to go through, may lose his life to tower shots. In fact, Krilla will die. Does end up buying out a little bit before he goes down. They're able to return that for a Tinker and an Omni. Still definitely a worthwhile trade, as long as Radiant don't lose any more here. Bray, relatively tanky, and Coach Adam might end up going down. Hookshot off the mark from Bray. There's going to be a Light Strike Array. Just catching out the creeps, and Lina taking advantage of the farm is Unforgiven now. Able to go onto the tower. There is going to be a TP in from Tinker as he respawns, and Lina, she just wants to back the hell out, will go in with the Light Strike Array, catches up the Clockwork, takes a Heat-Seeking Missile to the face, but she's on the run. She will get to high ground, goes through with another Dragon Slave. There's gonna be a disconnect from the Legion Commander, so she's not having the best game here. Oh, Lina does end up losing her life to a nice blink by the PA going through, and that's gonna be the rest of the Radiant now able to rotate in. Ricky has his Tricks of the Trade ready to go, so could jump in. That's a really fantastic thing. There's going to be a Haunted from the Spectre. Who does she reality in on? Looks like there's going to be the reality coming through on the back lines of this fight, trying to chase down Bray on the Tinker. But meanwhile, Bray on the Clockwork getting very, very low. The Cogs are going to do a fair amount of damage. Skywrath Mage will fall, courtesy of the laser onto the Tinker. And now SS in some serious trouble. Will end up going down here as a couple more hits should do it. Spectre, super, super speedy. Can PA catch up? Has the dagger. Will go through. The dagger secures the kill. Coach Adam wants to clean up onto Bray, but he might not have the mana to do so, and this is a very risky play with PA being so full health and so ready to go. Lina now back in the fight, ready to go, has the Laguna, really wants to get in range to polish off the Tinker. We'll see if she's able to do so, and it looks like she should be walking in right about now. Dragon Slave off the mark, Lightstrike Away off the mark, but does end up getting off the ultimate. There's going to be the Repel onto the PA, so she's magic immune for now. Lina now running away from the Spooky Lady charging in. And we'll see if Lina's able to juke this out. I think she's gonna fall. Another dagger should do the trick. She's bottling up to the best of her ability. Maybe not. Lightstrike Array comes through, but finally the PA goes in. Trapped under tower for a little bit. A Spectre now rejoins the fight, going through with the Spectral Dagger, taking a lot of damage. Ursa on the backlands. Oh, but the Blink and the Guardian Angel. The Guardian Angel doesn't catch out the PA, so she's still gonna have to take some damage for now. We'll get purified up. Omni is so low. They need something to catch us out. There is gonna be a Spectral Dagger. It will go through. It will catch out Omni. Omni will fall, but now the Cogs going through. SS in some trouble. Skywrath Mage falls once again. Spectre continuing to run. She's so low. A couple more daggers should do it, but Ursa just absolutely mauling down the PA. Unforgiven may end up falling here, just courtesy of more right clicks coming through. Bray, very little mana, has all his cooldowns ready to go, but they do end up getting a lot of kills there. So the fight recap was enormously spread out. This is not going to catch everything that went on there, because Radiant, they just kept throwing bodies into the fire, and they really needed to choose their battles. They needed to pick a target, get them down, and back off. Dire were able to just keep respawning and keep going back into the fight, and overall, they get a pick on the Spectre twice, they get a pick on the Ursa once, they get a pick on the Skywrath twice. Pretty much everyone went down at some point, and that's really not good. Radiant, they're really working with a strategy that can excel at the 15-20 minute mark, and you can't keep dying when you're doing that. You need the Spectre to be always farming, always fighting. She's going to have her Diffusal very soon, but Lina, she's going to be picking up the Yules. That's going to help her with her lockdown. But again, I think Radiant just need a little bit more communication on who they're going in, what spells they're going to commit, and when to back off, because that was the downfall. There's going to be a Laguna coming through onto Bray, but both heroes getting very, very low. No one falling just yet. Meanwhile, Coach Adam on the top does pick up the Aquila, which is kind of unusual for a Ricky. He doesn't really need that extra sustain on top of his Tranquil Boots, but hopefully it helps him out. Down bottom, Spectre TPing back in. Ursa does opt to go for the Mask of Madness, has not yet taken a Roche. I think that's a bit of a mistake. I think he needs to head in the pit sooner rather than later. We saw his item build at about 7-8 minutes. He could have taken the Roche then, but now at 13 minutes, it's really time for him to start excelling. So Ricky, a little bit salty about this pause coming up. We do want to wait for the Legion Commander. Her impact has been kind of minimal here, and we see that a lot with the jungle Legion Commander. She's just really not living up to her full potential. She's not getting XP as fast as she needs to. She has her duel ready to go, but without any damage items on top of the blink, that's really not going to be successful for her. She needs something to make herself worthwhile, so putting her in the safe lane, heck, even putting her in the off lane would have been a little more powerful. So we will continue to wait here. Hopefully Legion's able to reconnect. Looks like Clockwork will be going for the blade mail. That'll help him out a little bit. I think that'll make him a bit scarier when he hooks in, because for now, yeah, he's landed a couple clutch hooks and cogs, trapping in the Lina, trapping in the Ricky, but after that, I mean, Clockwork essentially just has to die, because there's really nothing he can do up against the damage of the Radiant. They're all peaking at this point. So the game is going to be unpausing as PA doesn't really want to wait for her partner in crime. There is going to be the Helm of the Dominator picked up on her. She's had that for a while. Oh, Lina could be getting very low. Will end up falling to the Tinker, but now Ricky going in with that Tricks of the Trade will get a kill. And now Coach Adam able to run away as there's no more vision on the side of the Dire. This is crucial for them to have. They need to have a Sentry. They need to have a Dust on any of them. Even the carries need to be picking up some of these things, because you saw Legion could have gone in for a really nice duel there, but didn't unfortunately have any way to catch out the Ricky before his Fade Time took effect, so Ricky only picking up 3 points in the Cloak and Dagger, but I guess the Fade Time is fine enough for that. Looks like Ursa will finally pick up the Roshan. One last swipe out of his ultimate will do the trick, so that's going to be the Aegis on top of a Mask of Madness and an Iron Talon. That's how you jungle. You need to be able to hop into the Rosh Pit relatively early. So Legion, yeah, she could take Ancients, but what's she doing out of that? She has 500 gold to work with on top of a Blink Talon. It's really not anything spectacular. It doesn't feel like she can go in for these duels and be indestructible just yet. There's going to be a hook in. Clockwork going through. We'll catch out Krilla, but now what? He's kind of stuck. Takes sounds from the Skywrath Mage. Mystic Flare is off the mark. There is going to be follow-up from the PA. Able to go and get a kill onto the Lina. And now Bray on the run here as Ursa chasing deep. There is going to be a Haunted from the Spectre. Spectral Dagger going through as well. We'll slow down Bray. The Diffusal Charge as well, keeping him low. SS getting some more health. We'll take a Heat-Seeking Missile after they get down this Clockwork. And that's going to be a huge amount of damage going the way of the Dire. Now the Dire are ready to punish the respawning Ursa. He wants to get out of here. He doesn't have his Blink yet, but he's going to pop into his ultimate form, taking a whole lot less damage. Just taking one last right click from the Tinker, rather, and it doesn't even tickle. So Dire got a whole lot out of that fight. Their Legion unfortunately disconnected again. They lost their Clockwork, but that is not anything compared to getting a Spectre and a mid Lina in return. So great play overall by the Dire. And for now, let's take a look at the overall XP. It's really, really close to zero. And gold slightly in favor of the Dire just after those couple of pickoffs. The towers are all still standing on both sides of the map, which is unusual seeing a lineup like this. Now Lina may end up taking another dagger to the face, will do so, but there's not going to be follow-up from PA. PA deciding not to blink in as Krilla comes in. He does have the Mystic Flare ready to go. It is going to be the rocket going through. Bray gets a nice hookshot onto the Lina. Not sure why she was hiding into the trees there. That was not the most efficient placement, but Bray actually walking right into the Mystic Flare. There is going to be a long-range dagger connecting onto Krilla, but again, no more blink as the rest of the Radiant, they're not exactly following up here. You would have liked to see a TP in from the Ursa, a TP in or Haunt in from the Spectre. That wasn't on a cooldown. Just to be able to make sure the Dire doesn't get any unnecessary advantage, and they are going to be able to pick off the tower most likely, unless they back off here and start hunting, and they are going to find out the Ursa. He's going to take a lot of damage. We'll go through into the ultimate form. He's negating a lot of the damage being thrown his way. There is going to be a dagger coming through from the PA if she can find him through the Fog of War. Looks like the dagger will cancel as it's slightly out of range now, and Bray doesn't have the hookshot for another 30 seconds. Coach Adam going through, he knows that there's no vision here on the side of the Dire. Again, still no vision. This is really unfortunate. They're going to pop down an Observer Ward, but that's not enough to find out the Ricky. There's going to be one sentry on Omni Knight. Can they place it? It's going to go, there's one in the mid lane, and Ricky hasn't walked up that far just yet. Coach Adam, he's kind of hunting for the Tricks of the Trade. He himself is going to also be going for a Diffusal Blade. Usually if you have one on your team, that's enough, but in this case, I think the Ricky could absolutely snipe people with it. Looks like PA will reveal that there is sentry vision of the Ricky in the mid lane as she slams out that dagger. There's going to be a silence in on the PA. There's no way she's getting out of this one. She takes all the spells there. Laguna finally getting her down. So she's a little bit salty about that. Looks like the Legion may end up abandoning this game. Seems like she tried so hard. Didn't get very far in the end. Oh, she comes back. She's reconnected. So we'll see what's going on here. Coach Adam has a couple more 100 gold to go until he's able to pick up his Diffusal Blade. Meanwhile, Lina, she did pick up her Yule Scepter. She's now got about 400 more gold to work with. She has died a decent amount. She's really got to be a little bit more survivable. Up against a Tinker, that's a tall order, because Tinker can just nuke you down. He's got so much burst damage with the laser, with the Heat-Seeking Missile. So BKBs, I think, are in order. It's a little bit unusual for a Spectre to build one up, but she has been dying in these fights a decent amount. That's going to be 3 deaths to her. Ursa, he's pretty much a natural BKB builder, and I'd like to see him go that next after his Blink Dagger is now completed and flown out. So it looks like Bray, he's also going to be still working on that Blade Mail, needs a couple more hundred gold before he's able to finally finish it off, and again, that's going to make him a little bit scarier. We'll see what PA is able to do here. She built up the Helm of the Dominator. She paused her Battle Fury to pick up the Phase Boots, which, yeah, that's necessary when you're trying to trace down speedy targets like the Lina, like the Ursa, like the Spectre, but you'd like to see her just stick with an item and get it done, because for now, even if she focuses all her farming attention on the Battle Fury, it's still not going to come out before 22 minutes. And that's pretty late for a PA that, you know, her team is really depending on her for a lot of damage early game. Skywrath Mage is going to be picking up the headdress, so it looks like he's going to go for a mech on top of the Arcane Boots. So hard 5 Skywrath Mage. You want to see him get something a little more utility, like a Force or an Atos. The mech is great, but he usually sits far enough back from the fight that he's not in range to mech everyone up. There is going to be SS actually haunting back into the depth of the fight, trying to get away now, and Bear just jumps in, slashes down the Omni Knight before he has any chance to react. He had no mana for his ult now, and now the other Bray getting low as well. Looks like he's going to be taking an Arcane Bolt. Skywrath Mage getting the kill for that, and there is going to be a Lightstriker ready to follow up the Yule Scepter from the Lina going over the Laguna as well. That's going to be a huge, almost wipe, as only Tinker is left alive, sitting in his base, just waiting for this misery to end. And, well, it looks like Krilla will finish up the headdress, but again, back to the point of Skywrath Mage with the Greaves. Usually he's far enough back in the fight that the real damage is being done far enough away that mech is out of range. And if he is deep enough in the fight to really need the mech, he's probably already dead. Skywrath Mage is not a huge survivor. He's got no base armor. He's got 700 HP at level 8. It's not really a hero you pick because you want him to be able to go into the fights and survive. You want him to be able to drop the spells, stay on the back lines, and, you know, pop out the silence. Once you get to the late game, Skywrath Mage is pretty much a point-click silence, and that's his utility, so you do want him to pick up items that can help the rest of his team. If he gets super rich, go for a Hex, go for an Atos, go for something on those lines. We've seen how useful the Lina's Yules can be. So Omni Knight here will pick up a headdress as well, so he's probably going for... My guess is a mech, but that's a little unusual for an Omni to pick up. There is going to be a Lina perhaps getting way too low, will turn in, there's going to be a Defusal Charge popped out onto the PA, now there's going to be a Guardian Angel as the Bear comes through, wants to do some splash damage, and Krilla going through, could pop out the Silence, could do that Mystic Flare and win, but will do that, gets the kill on the Omni Knight, and now PA running for her life. Will Krilla go in with another slow? There is going to be the Arcane Bolt flying through, Ursa going in with the slow as well, blinking to her own ally creeps, but it's not enough as Ursa's able to get a Dominating Streak going his way. He's now feeling really good as 2500 gold to work with Ursa in terms of net worth. He's second on the chart, only followed up by the PA, who has finished up her Battle Fury, but she's going to disconnect here as this game is not worth living. The Radiant, they've picked up their speed, and well, with the Legion Commander abandoning the game, it's looking pretty good for the Radiant. The Legion was never able to get online, didn't win a single duel, didn't attempt a single duel, and she's down for the count. Dire's middle tower is under attack. So we'll see the Radiant just kind of finish off this game. I doubt that Omni and Tinker are going to hold this. Tinker might end up trying his best, but he has been sitting in the base for an awfully long time. Did pick up the Boots of Travel, so he's trying his best here. Clockwork as well hops out of the fight, so it's just going to be the Tinker and the Omni. Omni's really trying. He does have 3k gold to work with from selling all of his team's items, and we'll see if he's able to pick up anything survivable off of that. But for now, the Radiant continuing to charge down the lane. The gold is just going fairly, very, very heavily in their favor. And now Lina looks like she might be going for an Aether Lens, picking up that Ring of Health. Bray going through may end up getting a kill. In fact, does kill off the Ricky, but Bray will immediately get punished for that as Ursa is just not messing around here. Has the Demon Edge. Let's see a Rapier here on the Ursa, just as a kind of YOLO pick. So for now, a nice hookshot in from Bray, and he's gonna get destroyed. That was a little bit hard to watch, man. Not safe for work, that content, because he just got absolutely blown the heck up. Tier 3s are broken, they're going in for the racks, and as the creeps roll through, it could be just easy tier 4s, quick game coming through now. Looks like that will be the case. Unforgiven, he's got about 1500 gold, so if we are going to see a Rapier, he needs a nice more chunk of pennies to be able to finish that one up. Meanwhile, Krilla looks like, yeah, he's gonna continue to work on the mechanism. He should be able to finish that up right about now. And now he's fresh out of mana, so there is a little bit of mana problems going on the side of the Radiant. They might want to pick up a second set of arcane boots, as Lina still has the brown boots. Could opt to level those up. Ursa gonna check the Roche. Oh! Oh, just a millisecond too late. There we go, he found it. And we'll go in, has the ultimate form ready to pop. He's gonna be doing some nice damage. Krilla could go in, pop the Lincoln Sphere. Just gonna help with the right clicks. This guy's right clicks kind of tickle. 81 base damage, but we'll see what's gonna happen with that. Ricky was able to get the pick onto the Tinker over here, and now Ricky might have to be running as Omni back in the fight has the ult, but gonna be confined to the base for now. Roshan does go down, goes the way of the Ursa once again. That's the second Roshan of the game, and for now, Radiant are feeling absolutely no pressure. They really shouldn't be feeling any pressure. It's 2v5, and the five that are on the Radiant are feeling pretty cohesive. They've got some nice fights. Spectre has been farming a good amount. Ends up picking up the Blade Mail, which is a bit unusual. Usually if you see the Diffusal Blade, you follow it up with a Manta, so your illusions can also get the passive mana break. But we'll see what Spectre wants to do. Again, not really confined into a build. It's not going to be a game that's really down to the wire. This is kind of Radiant, you know, enjoying the sensation of hitting creeps and pushing the lanes. So Ricky really opting to stay up here on the front lines of battle. May have to end up dealing with an Omni Knight who does pick up a Radiance with all that gold. That's what he was saving up for, so screw support, Omni. We are in the thick of it, and Omni will end up most likely going down. There is going to be the ultimate coming out from the Ricky, and not going to catch out pretty much any strikes on the bottom lane. Unforgiven might end up burning his Aegis here to Bray, who has not given up. There is still a Heat-Seeking Missile available, but the Haunting from the Spectre onto Bray is enough to spook him back and have him TP back to base with the Boots of Travel, so it's going to be more push coming out from the Radiant. We'll see what they're able to do here. Coach Adam might end up burning here, actually. Yeah, the Omni Knight does end up getting him down just with the passive from the Radiance. So he's learned not to mess with the Omni Knight. Ricky's down for almost a minute, in fact. We'll see how much the Tinker is able to hold off. He's spamming out those missiles like there's no tomorrow, but up against four pretty beefy Radiant heroes, there's not a whole lot you do. If we look at breakdown of levels, it's looking pretty good for the Radiant. Skywrath not getting as much XP, and that's pretty typical as he usually hangs on the back lines of the fight. And, well, yeah, it's time for the game to be over. Radiant most likely not going to mess around anymore. They've got the Ursa with the Aegis. He's got an MKB now as well, which is what that little green sword was for. No rapiers, unfortunately. We've got our casual racism in the chat, so you know it's an NA pub. And this could be the end. The tier 2 will fall. It's going to be an Omni Knight doing his best to clean out the waves. He does now have what looks like it's going to be a Yasha, so maybe going for a Manta. We'll see what he's able to do with this Radiance. He's going to go in, has the Repel ready to go, actually. Unforgiven burning down a fair amount. This Radiance doing some serious work, and SS not messing around, wants to go deep. Pops out the Blade Mail, doing a little bit of damage there to the Omni Knight. We're going to see Ursa getting very, very low. There's the Guardian Angel, actually. Bray in a really good position, snipes out the Skywrath Mage. Looks like Unforgiven will burn his Aegis, and now there's going to be a Lightstrike Array catching up Bray. There's going to be a Lugina from the Lina, does end up getting down the Tinker, and now it looks like the Omni will fall as well. There's going to be a buyback immediately from the Tinker, but Omni Knight, he does not have buyback after he picked up that Band of Elfskin. So it's only going to be the Tinker left to defend the rest of his base. Could use his DC'd heroes if he wants to. In fact, he does get down the Ursa. Nice laser there, just slapping down the bear. And SS going really deep, and Prey's going to get a double kill as Spectre just got a little bit overconfident. Now Lina, she's used up. She's very, very low. Buyback from the Spectre. Haunt back into the fight. Going to be cleaning up Bray most likely, as he has no hookshot. He's got no boots. He's got no movement speed. So double kill for SS, tossing out a Spectral Dagger into the base. Maybe objective should be the focus, but I think Radiant are just having a little bit of fun with this one. Yeah, they're gonna go, they clean up the tier 3. Lina now did finish off that Aether Lens. Spectre, she has her level 2 Diffusal Blade. It's gonna be pretty nice for her. And Coach Adam actually picking up what looks like a Basher. He's got the Yasha, so I think the Basher is the right choice here. Just having the casual Yasha is good enough for Ricky. Right now, the D-Gen Aura doing a lot of work. Ricky going in, punishing the PA a little bit. She no longer has items, so she is not as scary as she used to be. There's going to be a Diffusal Charge coming out onto the Omni Knight, so he is falling once again. That is everyone dead on the side of the Dire, or everyone dead, or disconnected at least, as there's no more buyback from the Tinker, no more buyback from the Omni Knight, and the Tier 4s are going to be under siege very soon. So for now, it looks like Radiant, they're really not feeling the pressure. They're just kind of rotating in. Unforgiven, able to go farm up whatever he'd like. Looks like he might be going for the Aghanim Scepter as he picks up a point booster. Could go for something cheeky like an Octarine. Could also be going for the Scotty, but I'm guessing it's an Ags because you usually start with the little pink guy when you pick up the Ags. And, well, March of the Machines are flying through, cleaning up the creeps, but it's only Bray alive, and he's trying to do the work of five heroes. I don't know if this is gonna be successful. I think it's just gonna be a case of whenever the Radiant decide to go up and push and hit the final nail into the coffin, that's gonna be it for the game. So it looks like Ricky has picked up the Demon Edge, so he's also gonna be picking up an MKB. There's going to be a Haunt in. Spectre just going deep, not messing around here, going straight onto the Omni Bray. Going to get Yulzed up into the air. All of the disconnected heroes there with no items are just going to be taking some serious damage from the creeps. There is going to be a Laguna out from the Lina, able to finish off the disconnected Clockwork. And now PA scrambling back to base, unsure who's microing her now. But either way, small buildings under attack. And that could be the Ancient next, as the Tier 4 is now going to be whacked on by the creeps. SS feeling really good, picking up the Reaver. May end up trying to go for a Heart. Looks like Legion wandering out of the base, maybe looking for a duel. Unforgiven, actually, diving very deep. There's going to be no Aegis on him, so he can't really mess around all that much. Dagger comes through, and it's going to be a nice coup de grace popping onto the Ursa, but, well, creeps are doing their work here onto the Tier 4 tower. The final tower, we're dropping bottles on the floor. Let's get messy with it. Lina's flying in some mangoes. We'll figure out what's going to go on here as Legion, once again, hopping out of the base, and Ancient is exposed, wailed on by the melee creeps on the side of the Radiant, and Radiant just having fun with their food. Now going through onto the Lina, Legion, there we go. I was going to say, Lina kills the Legion, and all got mushed into one word, and now the Ancient half health. There's going to be a nice long-range hookshot from the Clockwork, maybe able to get down Krilla, but not even a little bit, as Ursa is just too big. He has a double kill now. It looks like Omni, he did everything he could. He transitioned into the carry his team needed, but when his team was two people, it's just not enough. Up against a lineup with a Spectre, a Ricky, a Skywrath, an Ursa, and a Lina. So overall, laning went in favor of the Dire in terms of the mid lane. Even the bottom Clockwork wasn't really killed off all that much, but unfortunately Jungle Legion, who also is Disconnect Legion, is not the carry that the Dire needed. So hope you guys enjoyed the cast. It was pretty fun to watch a quirky little game like this. I'm reminded of some of my pubs sometimes. And, well, if you have any feedback on how I can improve it as a caster, please feel free to leave it below in the YouTube comments, or you can tweet me at Android, A-N-N-E-E, DROID. If you have a replay you'd like me to cast, feel free to submit me the match ID at anycasts@gmail.com. So again, thank you guys for watching and have an awesome day.